Watch your step around these words, guys. They're gonna get you, they're gonna get you in the end. I swear, it's not a disease, it's just a game of pretend. A game of pretend.
Hey YouTube, it's MJF here. I want to give a little story. Tell a little story about my ninjas and how I became the big ninja fan of 2012 to 2013 and still on. So it started with an idea. Started with a stupid idea that I can make a lockdown with rabbits. With Rescue Rabbit, Ninjas, Dark Samoric, and Anti-Spell Fragments. I'm not going to go into detail about it because it's too freaking long. It sucks. So what I was left over with the deck was Ninjas. And two Samorics. And Transformations. So, I decided to make a Samoric deck. Dark Samoric Ninjas. That was good. Borderline good. And the borderline good and bad. It has flaws. A lot of... I didn't like it very much. But I played it. I played it. I didn't care. I played some more Ninjas. Until they became obsolete. Because I took them apart. Because I wanted to try out a different Ninja deck. But, long run. So, I played the Ninjas. Played some more for a while. Didn't like it. Well, it's not that I didn't like it, that it wasn't winning. So then, I went on to... So then, when I started playing White Dragon Ninja, I played every ninja deck. I tried every ninja. I've tried Atlantean Ninjas, which I'm building next, because I'm building into a totally separate deck. So I'm going to have two different ninja decks. I'm also building CWs because it's for shits and giggles. CW. And, yeah, so. When I decided to run White Dragon Ninja, people were saying, oh, run Super Transformation Chaos Dragons. I didn't like the Chaos Dragons idea. I like the super transformation idea. But then, let me just give you a shout out. People who've been helping me out through the building and testing out this deck, Ventus Phantom, he helped me find a lot of these cards. Without him, I wouldn't have the one of the white dragon ninjas I have right now, and a cave zone, and also the two Excaliburs, and the blade armors. And the Abyss Dweller, and the Photon Pop Operative, and the C39. Hey, I wouldn't have the deck without him. Just check out his channel. He's the one who took me to his locals, which I usually go to now for Yu-Gi-Oh! It's called First Choice. It's in, Bayport? One of those two. It's on, like, something in that. And that's where I got all the ninja stuff I needed, except one thing, so with that bottom line, and a few side deck cards. And, yeah. So, when I first started running White Dragon Ninja, it was Christmas Day. I opened up, I got for Christmas, Hanzaten. Yes, I forgot to open up. I got so excited that I forgot to open it for YouTube. I forgot. I'm sorry, guys. I forgot how to do it. I got like, oh my god. I had a cork in. Right in front. My dad, stop having a heart attack. I'm like, having a heartgasm. I didn't make that. What I pulled out of it was an Evil Tile Westlow. Super. And a secret White Dragon Ninja. I find kind of ironic because I was running ninjas for so long at that time. And I also pulled it out of a white, Hanzo deck. And so I love my ninjas, I swear. I've gone through so many decks. You guys know. I've done so many new decks. For all you guys who've been sticking by this channel, you know I did so many decks. I went through Ninja. Well, I'm still going through Ninja. I went through Glad Beast, Final Countdown. I went from Crystal B, Steel Swarm. Well, I don't know if I had Steel Swarm at the time when I first started this channel. I had Heroes when I first started playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Fairies when I first started playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Again. When I first started playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Again, my first deck was, thanks to Dom Dom, as you guys would know, 555 Dom, 555 Dom, 555 Dom Wyvern, Dom Wyvern, 555, something like that. I forgot. He's also been, I wouldn't say, big help. He's the one who got me back into Yu-Gi-Oh! Because of Bakugan. We hung out because of Bakugan. And then one day, like, I play Yu-Gi-Oh! And I'm like, I haven't played Yu-Gi-Oh! Since I was a kid. When I was a kid, I used to gamble my cards. I used to have a gambling issue when it came to Yu-Gi-Oh! When I was a kid, that's why I quit. Me and my friends gambled for cards. I don't recommend it. Don't do it, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. We used to have this whole thing. If you lost, you gamble a card. If you lose your card, we suck. Now, looking back, we suck. I could kick 10-year-old Sheen's ass anytime. Anytime. Not literally. So, yeah, that's right. I'm looking to the future. I'm looking to the best way. Yeah, I'm good. Yeah. No puns. I swear, no puns. So, yeah. So, ninjas. I tested out with one white dragon ninja. Glad to God also. Big part of big influence. He made the videos of ninjas. Also like White Dragon. I watched all their videos. So shout out for them. They're the ones who put up the ninja videos, the deck profiles, and ninja discussions, the duels, and then I'm like, I'm going to work hard on this stuff. I'm going to work hard and make it clear. Because I just want Dragon things and think these ninjas have enough support to pop, but I will pop. I will top with ninjas. I will work harder on them than I've ever worked harder on any deck. Even Crystal Beasts. Yes, I'm Captain GX and I'm not running Crystal Beasts. I love my Crystal Beasts until Ventus Phantom. But I'm not gonna get into that. I'm also gonna leave Ventus Phantom. You already know Izumite and Fact of God channels, probably, most likely, if you don't. Look them up. They're very famous YouTubers. So yeah, that's my story behind me running ninjas. We're gonna get to the deck profile in the next video. So yeah, see you guys.